Dr. Novellus here. Today, I'm going to share with you how you can pair ChatGPT with Munch in order to supercharge the use of your long-form video content. Step 1, use ChatGPT to brainstorm your video content ideas. Step 2, record and publish your public video. Step 3, cut and paste your public video link into your project in Munch. Step 4, allow Munch to analyze your long-form content. Step 5, review all of the short-form content generated by Munch, decide which content would be best for advertising your channel, and post. All of us know that when we spend all of this time and energy creating long videos, we want to repurpose that content into short form if possible. If you're like me, you spent so much time looking for those key points in the videos when it's funny or engaging or exciting. Munch lets you reclaim your time by automatically finding those key points using AI. When I found out about this, I was super excited. So let me show you how you can use both ChatGPT and Munch in order to figure out your video strategy. Let's jump in. I'm in ChatGPT. I've already logged in. I want some video ideas. Can you provide 10 video ideas using Canva and ChatGPT for YouTube? As you see on the screen, Canva quickly generates these 10 video ideas, which I can peruse. Now you can use a lot of other softwares to tell you, hey, is this SEO friendly? Is there a high volume of search requests for this particular content when figuring out which video to actually do? But this helps you kind of brainstorm the options for your video. So how to create some YouTube thumbnails with Canva, top 10 Canva hacks for graphic design, Canva versus Photoshop. Not only does ChatGPT provide the title, it also tells you what to do. Show content creators how to leverage Canva to design visually appealing infographics. Integrate ChatGPT to suggest infographic content ideas or provide feedback. You can start off your video creation journey by doing some initial research and brainstorming with the help of ChatGPT. As I mentioned in other videos, this process is similar to brainstorming with a team member. So you can go back and forth with ideas. If you don't like any of these ideas, you can ask for more. If you want the ideas to be different, you can adjust the prompt to have differences. So I've already recorded a video leveraging ChatGPT and Canva. So what I could have done is generated those ideas in advance and then come over here and created this video. I dropped the link here if you want to watch it, but we're good to go. Next, we'll go to Munch, get Munch. You can sign in with your Google account. If you already have a YouTube account, if you sign in with Google, since it's the same, that is the easiest. Other forms. What I did was copy this share link from my video and paste it into Munch. After you cut and paste the link, it will search through that content in order to determine which videos have the most engagement and which videos that people will like if they are looking at short form content in the future. This process for me took about 45 minutes for Munch to process my video. And it came up with these 6 short form content clips that I could use for social media. It also has keywords that you can use if you want to sort the content by keywords. Some of these aren't that great, like comments. Like, nobody searches for comments, I believe. So I think they need some help in this keyword section. But having 6 pieces of content that you can use is great. So I'm going to show you this first one that they put together. This is all you have to do. So you start off with a template. This is my favorite template that I put together. This is my favorite quote: after you get what you manifest it as, for the discipline to keep it and the wisdom to multiply it. So all you have to do is go to your apps, look for Bulk Create, upload that CSV file for Canva. Here you go. The code to your text. So I did the right click. I am on a Mac, so you know how to right click, click connect data. boom, right? You can make this bigger, smaller, depending on what you're looking for. It's best to do this when there's only one item in that Canva file instead of a list of 12. I know a lot of us just build in over time, but just start with that one template and then you click continue. Do you want to generate all of them? You can actually select which quotes you want and click generate the 29 pages. And as you can see here, we have generated these quotes for these 29 pages, right? These 30 quotes are here in Canva and it's ready just like that. And all we have to do now is decide what our posting schedule is. It's so easy to do this. I found that it was pretty great. I'm going to look through the rest. As you can see, when you look at this, the reels vary in length from almost a whole minute and 30 seconds to things a little shorter. At this point, what you would do is watch all of them to see if they meet your requirements and then go from there. While you can use ChatGPT to generate those video ideas, and then Munch will go through that long form video and highlight the best points for your short form content, I believe that you would get the most bang from your buck if you remixed the short form content and made it more customized for the audience. As you can see here, I tested the Munch software with my shorts and it has like the lowest views of any of my shorts. Based on that, and of course, the standards of the industry, it seems pretty evident that people will prefer content specifically made for short form ingestion versus content simply spliced from that long form video. But you could still use all of these videos generated from Munch in the creation process and it will still save you a lot of time. In conclusion, I think using ChatGPT and Munch as part of your marketing strategy will save you lots of time and energy and help you create many more engaging reels. In this video, we discussed the 5 steps on how you can combine the AI power of ChatGPT and Munch to supercharge your long form and short form video content. Stay tuned for another ChatGPT video next week.